Ahead in Indonesia Now, an active police general is arrested in a graft case. South Korean sunken ferry captain escaped the death penalty. And a trip to an exotic lake in the slopes of the highest mountain in Java. Hello and welcome to Indonesia Now from Jakarta. Selamat berjumpa lagi, I'm Andini Effendi, and a special welcome to our viewers in Balikpapan. The anti-graft agency KPK on Tuesday arrested a one-star police general for his role in a graft-ridden driving simulator procurement project. Former Deputy Chief of the National Police Traffic Corps, Korlantas Didik Purnomo, was named as graft suspect since August 2012 and has been grilled for 2 months. A number of high-ranking police officers have been linked to the 2009 procurement project, including Inspector General Joko Susilo, who was already given a verdict of 18 years in prison. The case has cost 144 billion rupiah, or almost 12 million US dollars in state losses. Still on corruption cases, KPK on Tuesday also questioned People's Consultative Assembly MPR Speaker Zulkifli Hasan over alleged illegal forest exploitation permits in Bogor, West Java, and Riau. Hasan was Minister of Forestry at the time. KPK already named Riau Governor Anas Ma'mun and Bogor Region Rahmat Yasin as suspects. Ma'mun was suspected of accepting bribes releasing forest reserve for palm oil industry to be used for other purposes industry. Yasin, on the other hand, is suspected of being paid to allow a protected reserve to be used for a housing project. Jakarta's acting governor Basuki Cahayapurnama on Tuesday filed an official recommendation to the Minister of Law and Human Rights in a bid to disband the hardline group Islam Defenders Front, or FBI. Purnama said FBI's protest led by FBI Chairman Muhammad Rizik Shihab were offensive, intolerant, and incited hatred, all violated the 1945 Constitution. His action was a response to FBI's relentless protest against the plan to inaugurate Purnama as governor. The protests were joined by city officials such as Abraham Lunggana and Muhammad Taufik, speakers of the City Council. Jakarta Council Friday named Purnama as the definite governor despite the absence of members opposing the appointment. President Joko Widodo is completing a series of official overseas trips, his first since taking office on October 20th. President Widodo's first stop was the APEC summit held in Beijing, China. He presented various investment opportunities that Indonesia has to offer. Widodo also held a bilateral meeting with several prominent leaders. At the ASEAN summit, he stressed that Indonesia demand a fair trade on ASEAN community. Meanwhile, in front of the G20 leaders, President Widodo later today is to share his experiences in bureaucracy and economic reforms during his tenure as Surakarta mayor and Jakarta governor. Who can resist sweets nowadays? Indonesia Now's Gita Larasati takes us to a candy store which has a unique concept of making handmade candies.
Sticky Candy Store is an Australian-based company founded in 2000. The store then expanded into the US and across Asia in countries such as Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, and Indonesia. The store offers different flavors. Customers can also design their own candies for all purposes, including weddings, corporate promotions, and birthdays. Besides selling candies, Sticky also sells lollipops. Sticky's bright colored stores and beautiful eye-catching displays are their way to attract customers. The stores also allow customers watch talented candy makers mold and sculpt sugar dough and mixtures into interesting designs.
Rasanya enak, bentuknya lucu.
The products are all handmade, have no added preservatives, and are gluten-free. The price ranges from 12,000 rupiah, or around $1, to 85,000 rupiah, or $7 per packaging. The business turnover is 5 to 7 million rupiah per day and usually doubles in the weekend. With around 2 billion rupiah or $160,000 to invest in a new store, Sticky already has open stores each in West Jakarta and Tangerang. Gita Larasati, Metro TV.
Asia's markets mostly rose this week. Here's a quick rundown of the week-on-week numbers. Indonesia Now will continue shortly with Asia's top stories, including the sentence for the captain and crew of South Korea's sunken ferry Sewol, and an interview with the man behind White House social media strategies.